निवेदिता। न्यूजीलैंड ने सेमीफाइनल में भारत को 18 रन से हराकर वर्ल्ड कप फाइनल में जगह बना ली है, लेकिन वही भारत की हार के बाद अब लोग अंपायर द्वारा धोनी को रनआउट देने के फैसले पर सवाल उठा रहे हैं। दरअसल भारत की टीम 240 रन के लक्ष्य का पीछा कर रही थी, लेकिन मैच की शुरुआत में ही पहले रोहित शर्मा, फिर विराट कोहली और तीसरे नंबर पर केएल राहुल, यानी कि 5 रन के अंदर 3 बड़े और शानदार खिलाड़ी महज एक एक रन बनाकर आउट हो गए। अब भारत का स्कोर था 5 रनों पर 3 विकेट, जिसके बाद पंत ने मोर्चा संभाला, लेकिन वो भी ज्यादा देर कीवियों के आगे टिक नहीं पाए और महज 32 रन बनाकर कैच आउट हो गए। न्यूजीलैंड से एक के बाद एक झटके मिलने के बाद जडेजा और धोनी की जोड़ी ने भारत को 208 रन तक पहुंचाया, जिसे देखकर भारत की स्थिति कुछ हद तक मजबूत लगने लगी, लेकिन अफसोस कि जडेजा भी 77 रन बनाकर कैच आउट हो गए, जिसके बाद मैच फिर भारत की पटरी से उतरकर न्यूजीलैंड के हाथों में आ गया। लेकिन अभी भी भारत की उम्मीद धोनी से थी कि शायद आज धोनी का बल्ला कुछ तो कमाल दिखाएगा, लेकिन 49वें ओवर की तीसरी गेंद पर धोनी ने फाइन लेग की तरफ शॉट खेला, जिस पर एक रन बेहद आराम से लेने के बाद धोनी ने दूसरा रन लेने की ठानी और यही धोनी गलती कर बैठे, क्योंकि मार्टिन गुप्टिल ने सटीक थ्रो लगाकर एमएस धोनी को संकट में ला दिया, जिसके बाद मैदान पर लगे स्क्रीन पर सबकी निगाहें टिक गईं और टीवी अंपायर ने रिप्लाई कर धोनी को रनआउट करार दिया, जिसके बाद अब धोनी के रनआउट को लेकर सोशल मीडिया पर बवाल शुरू हो गया है। दरअसल ट्विटर पर आईसीसी ने धोनी के रनआउट का वीडियो शेयर किया है, जिसको लेकर एक फोटो में ग्राफिक्स भी दिखाया जा रहा है, जिसमें दिख रहा है कि न्यूजीलैंड के 6 खिलाड़ी सर्कल के बाहर खड़े थे। इसी को लेकर लोग अब भारत की हार के लिए सीधे सीधे अंपायर के गलत फैसले को जिम्मेदार बता रहे हैं। लोगों का कहना है कि धोनी जिस गेंद पर रनआउट हुए थे उसे नो बॉल दिया जाना चाहिए था, यानी कि अंपायर ने धोनी के रनआउट के फैसले में पावर प्ले के दौरान फील्डिंग के नियमों को नजरअंदाज किया। तीसरे पावर प्ले में 30 गज के दायरे के बाहर अधिकतम 5 खिलाड़ी ही बाहर रह सकते हैं, लेकिन धोनी के रनआउट के वक्त 6 खिलाड़ी सर्कल से बाहर थे, जिसको लेकर ये भी कहा जा रहा है कि ये टीवी ग्राफिक्स की गलती थी। वहीं एक यूजर ने ट्वीट कर कहा कि अंपायरिंग में गलती, क्या वो इसे वर्ल्ड कप के सेमीफाइनल में सहन कर सकते थे? सर्कल के बाहर 6 खिलाड़ी, वो तीसरे पावर प्ले में कितनी देर इस तरह खेले? वहीं एक यूजर ने ट्वीट किया कि कितनी बढ़िया अंपायरिंग, महेंद्र सिंह धोनी को रनआउट नहीं दिया जाना चाहिए था क्योंकि गेंद नो बॉल थी, धोनी को खेलना चाहिए था और भारत जीत जाता। क्या महान वर्ल्ड कप है, क्या महान अंपायरिंग है। वहीं दूसरे यूजर ने कहा, क्या मैंने अकेले ने देखा ये, धोनी के रनआउट होने से पहले सर्कल से 6 खिलाड़ी बाहर थे, पता नहीं ये अंपायरिंग फॉल्ट है या ग्राफिक्स एरर, क्या धोनी अब भी रनआउट है। तो देखा आपने, तमाम लोग सोशल मीडिया पर अंपायर पर अपना गुस्सा निकालते नजर आ रहे हैं, लेकिन एक नजर उस नियम पर भी डाल लेते हैं जो नो बॉल को लेकर होता है। क्या कहते हैं नियम? नियम के मुताबिक जितने खिलाड़ी 30 गज के घेरे में होने चाहिए उससे कम या ज्यादा होने पर नो बॉल करार दी जाती है। नो बॉल रहने पर रन आउट के अलावा किसी और तरीके से बल्लेबाज आउट नहीं हो सकता, यानी कि अगर अंपायर ने नो बॉल दी होती तो भी धोनी रन आउट होते। लेकिन नियमों की ही बात करें तो नो बॉल पर बल्लेबाज सिर्फ रन आउट हो सकता है और धोनी भी रन आउट थे। हालांकि इस गेंद को अंपायर नो बॉल देता तो शायद धोनी दूसरे रन के लिए नहीं दौड़ते और मैच का नतीजा शायद कुछ और होता।
It is a little bit different, if I have to be totally honest. League stages, when you know that you just need a victory to qualify, then the team is a bit more relaxed and, you know, you can go out there and try a few things. But I think knockout games, you need to be very precise at the same time being intense. So I think that balance, this is more similar to, you know, the toughest situations you'll get in Test cricket, where you have to be absolutely precise, but your intent cannot go down. So I think decision making will be crucial, and both teams are experienced enough to have played these games. New Zealand was in the finals last time and they know how to play knockout games. They've had a wonderful World Cup again, so the quality side. But yeah, on the day, whichever team is more brave in being calculative, I think that team stands a better chance to win. So yeah, we understand that combination. We've made it to a lot of knockout games and finals. So it's up to both the teams to bring their A game, and then whoever handles pressure better is the team that's going to come out on top. And we certainly are looking forward to doing that.
Virat, what's your assessment of the New Zealand attack and how do you sum up the performance of the Indian attack so far?
Well, if according to me, I think our bowling attack has been up there with the best, if not the best bowling attack in the competition. I think the way we have bowled in low scoring games, even coming back into the match when the guys have been hit, I think we have shown a lot of character. And New Zealand attack has always been a very balanced bowling attack. Their pacers are very consistent. Mitchell Santner brings in a lot of control with his skills in the middle overs. So, yeah, they're a team which has always been a very consistent team. So we know that up against them, we'll have to be very, very disciplined. At the same time, we'll have to play very correct cricket to, you know, score runs against them because they bowl in good lines and lengths and they know exactly what they're doing. So we have to be absolutely sure of what we are doing. And that's the kind of challenge that team brings. They put the ball in the right areas and then, you know, make you play good shots. So it's going to be a nice battle. We've played against them a lot. But yeah, they're a quality side and a very, very potent bowling attack.
Virat, personally, you've never not been in a World Cup semi. So what was the mood like after the win? And you've seen both results too. So what is the win like? What is the mood like after the win in Mohali and after the loss in Sydney?
Very, obviously, very contrasting. The win in Mohali was my first World Cup and, you know, we make it to the finals and playing at home and the whole atmosphere was brilliant. So getting to experience that for me as a youngster was something magnificent. 2015, I was more of an established player and, you know, not being able to get the team across the line was obviously very disappointing for all of us. But this time around, because the format has been different and we understand that the tournament has been long, guys have put in a lot of effort day in, day out, and then to realize, okay, we have achieved the first goal that we wanted to, which was to qualify for the semis. That gives you an extra boost of energy. Okay, now we can focus totally on these, you know, the remaining two games that we have in the tournament and try to bring our A game and take up the intensity even more. So I think that incentive is very important to realize as a team that you have done what you wanted to do as a first goal. And now you can be even more, you know, intense and energetic when you step onto the field. So it just gives you a bit more energy knowing that we're entering the last phase of the tournament and bodies are not going to be as fresh. But then these kind of things motivate you even further to put in more energy. So we're quite happy after qualifying.
Virat, Rohit has got 500 so far. You know, it's unusual that you haven't got any. So are you missing the 100, you know, considering the consistency with which you get them? Are you missing a century?
No, not at all. I mean, it's been a different kind of role that I've had to play in this World Cup. And as the captain of the team, I've been open to playing any kind of role that the team wants me to. So it's great that, you know, Rohit is scoring so consistently, which means that coming in the later in half of the innings, you have to play a different role, which is controlling the middle overs and letting guys like Hardik and, you know, Kedar and MS in the past few games and now Rishabh come out and express themselves. So I've understood that, you know, roles can vary a lot in one-day cricket, depending on the time you step into bat. And I've been very happy with holding one end and, you know, letting guys express themselves, striking at 150, 160 or 200 if the team needs. And then I know I can accelerate in the end. Personal milestones, honestly, is something that no one ever focuses on. Rohit said the same thing the other day. He's only trying to do the best for the team. And then in that process, special things happen, which is something that I've always believed in my career so far. And I could never imagine that I could get the number of hundreds I have. And the only focus has always been team. So I think playing a team sport, you need to be able to adapt. And I'm very, very happy doing that role. And I hope he gets two more so that, you know, we can win two more games because it's an outstanding achievement. Never seen anyone get 500s in a World Cup, be any tournament. So World Cup is all the more pressure and he's just been outstanding. And as I said, he deserves all the credit. And according to me, he's at the moment the top ODI player in the world.
Virat, just back to the 2008 under-19 game. I know you said that you didn't envisage you playing off against Kane again, but did you see him at that time as being a future superstar? And how crucial is getting him out early to you guys winning the game?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's not even 2008. I remember 2007, we went to New Zealand and we're playing, you know, an under-19 test match and he played a shot off one of our fast bowlers who was quick. off the back foot, and I remember standing in slips and just telling guys standing at slip, I've never seen anyone play a shot like that. And he was special, along with a couple of more guys which didn't make it, surprisingly, but he was always the standout player. And you could see, even when we played New Zealand in New Zealand on that under-19 tour, and then yes, the World Cup again, he was quite special for them. So we always knew he has the special ability to go all the way, and now he's controlling the tempo of the game for New Zealand every game that he plays, and he's contributing so well. And he's a lovely guy, we get along very well. So yeah, he's always been, the main guy for them, along with Ross, who have performed really consistently. So I think those two guys have shared the load so far, and a lot will depend on them, obviously, because they've been playing well. And according to us, from our team point of view, getting both of them early will be crucial, because we know how strong they can be together in a partnership. So yeah, it's not to mention here, but Kane and Ross are probably their main guys in the batting lineup.